Hi, friends. Today we're going to read some informational text, nonfiction text, about terrific turtles. Remember, when we're looking at nonfiction text, we're thinking about those details, those nonfiction features that help us make meaning of what we're reading. And there's different features that we've talked about. One of the features that we've talked about is photographs, and you'll see that there's lots of photographs in this article. Another feature that we talk about sometimes is headings. And notice terrific turtles. That's the heading. Headings give hints. It's a way that the author tells us what he or she wants us to learn. Another way that authors give us hints in nonfiction text articles is by using captions or vocabulary. And in this piece, we're going to notice some bright red words, and that means that those are tricky words or new vocabulary. It's new words that we're going to learn the meaning of. We may not know it before, but it's going to help us understand the article. And the reason that it's in red in this one is to help bring our eye to it so we pay attention to it. So those are some three key features of nonfiction text. We'll notice that nonfiction text features include photographs, headings, and vocabulary. Let's go ahead and read. Terrific Turtles. And this article was actually published by Time for Kids. Since we're working on rainforest this week, I thought that this would go with this nicely. Sea turtles are ancient creatures. They have been around since the time of the dinosaurs. There are seven species of sea turtles. The reptiles spend most of their life underwater. Ready to learn more? Keep reading. Remember how I mentioned that the words in red were going to be new vocabulary? There's two of them in this paragraph. Let's take a look. Sea turtles are ancient creatures. Ancient is a word. It's a tricky word to say, and it's a word that you probably don't know the meaning of. It means a really, really, really long time ago. So long. And one way that the author helps us understand that if we don't know the vocabulary is the next sentence says, they have been around since the time of the dinosaurs. And so my background schema, my background knowledge tells me that's a really, really long time ago. That's ancient. There are seven species. Another new vocabulary word. Species is a different type or a different classification of sea turtles. So a group. So species, we are the human species. We're kind of animal, a mammal, and we are the human species. And then you could break that up into other categories. Species is another word for category or classification or group. Keep reading. A clear view. A sea turtle's eyes are like swimming goggles. They help the turtle see clearly underwater. What's the new vocabulary word we're supposed to notice in this paragraph? Yes, you're right. Goggles. And I'm noticing that this picture really helps emphasize that word. Now, here where we live in New Jersey, we're reading this in the summer where it's hot, and we live in a place where a lot of people go swimming in pools and lakes and creeks. So lots of us probably know what the word goggles means because we wear them, right? Yeah, they protect our eyes when we go underwater. But there are kids in other places who maybe don't have that kind of background knowledge. Maybe they don't know the word goggles. Smooth sailing. Sea turtles have smooth shells. This makes it easy for them to swim. Do you see a pattern on this shell? Let's take a look. I think it's just beautiful. Look at the pattern on the shell. I'm noticing dark and light. What do you notice? Take a look. Time to eat. Sea turtles don't have teeth, but their sharp jaws slice through food. Sea turtles like to eat jellyfish, crabs, seagrass, and algae. This turtle is about to eat a jellyfish. I see that from the picture. Algae is a vocabulary word you may or may not know. When I hear the word algae, I think of kind of like a green, mossy, like underwater sort of thing. Algae is what grows when there's like a lot of moisture and water. And that makes sense because what we're talking about is turtles that live in the water. Cycle of life. Female sea turtles lay eggs in the sand. The eggs hatch. Baby sea turtles are born. They head toward the ocean. Now, remember how I mentioned that headings give hints? Headings give us a hint of what the author wants us to learn in a whole passage or just a little article or a little subsection. This heading, Cycle of Life, gives us a hint about what we're supposed to learn in this paragraph. We're supposed to learn that the life cycle is going to have a beginning and an end, and it starts all over again. So for example, the mama, she lays her eggs in the ground. It looks like she uses her flippers to cover up the eggs. They grow, they hatch, they emerge, then they become adult turtles and they lay eggs and the cycle starts all over again. So it means that it's just continuous. It just keeps on happening. The heading gives me a hint of what I'm supposed to learn. Did you know plastic litter is harmful to sea turtles? Plastic bags can look like jellyfish. Turtles think they are food. Don't worry, a jellyfish is shown here. They want us to know that in this picture, it's not a plastic bag. It is an actual jellyfish. So let's think about what we were doing for our purpose for reading today. I talked about how I want you to think about nonfiction text features. Those are the details in informational text that help me understand things as a reader. Our goal for today was to think about three key nonfiction text features: photographs, headings, and new vocabulary. When you read informational text or nonfiction, meaning that it's real, you can use those three nonfiction text features to help you make meaning of all of your words. Bye.